uninterrupted view of the Manhattan Bridge. Okay. But when it was built in 1903, it was a Jewish synagogue. Today, it is a Buddhist temple and the 99-cent store sharing the same building. Again, only in New York. Now, you think that's a little unusual? Look down the street to your left. You see, this is East Broadway. Underneath that section of the Manhattan Bridge is a building that the rooftop is almost touching the bottom of the bridge. It's a shopping mall. When the subway goes overhead and you're inside, you can feel a slight vibration go through the building. If you keep going left here for four blocks, you arrive at the beginning of Mott. Oregon's nobody sees Canal Street. Here's the other side of Canal Street with the traffic light to your left. If you go left 8 blocks here, to where the machine's going to be, you can stop. If you want to explore this part of Chinatown, our next stop is just up ahead, the lower east side corner of Allen and Crab Street. Anybody here for the lower east side stop? That we just call it the Bowery. Now the Bowery has come a long way. It has been completely transformed into New York City's lighting district with its many chandelier and light bulb stores, and also home to some of the finest Vietnamese cuisine in town. Check out all these wonderful old buildings around us. Look at these on the right. These were all built during the late 19th century. As a result of having so many wonderful older structures with us today, they do quite a bit of filming in this neighborhood. More recently, the sadly recently canceled show Life on Mars, based on the British production of the same name. I have one more bridge to show you. The next traffic light on the right is the Williamsburg Bridge, which will connect you to the Williamsburg community in Brooklyn. And here it is, that bridge was from the 1914
State building, the tallest building in our city. We were there earlier today. We
will be stopping there again later. Built in 1931, the height of the top of the antenna, 1,474 feet. The antenna by itself is the size of a 20-story building. There it is, looking lovely from any angle. You should see what it looks like in the evening. The building actually overlooks Grand Central. Black dome on top is the General Assembly Building where the delegates meet. All right, anybody here from the United Nations? Anybody here who should get off and visit the United Nations? Anybody on either level? Going once, going twice. Any fans of, do we have on this bus any fans of Donald Trump?
Yes!
Oh, one person. Usually I get total silence.
Oh, another
show. The reason I ask is because I'm on this apartment building in the world. It has 79 people. We'll be able to look inside the lobby. That's how close we're going to get to it. And later, we'll show you the building where he fires people on television.
Oh,
that's the Trump Midtown
show.
Tower. The one that you see on The Apprentice.
I love that show.
Very modern.
He was supposed to build a tower in Florida, but what happened to that? No go.
Did they tell him no? No permits?
No, I guess he tried to speak too long and they just said no.
Now he's going to afford to do it.
Okay, the German consulate building on the left, the building with the two flags out front. We have lots of consulates and embassies in this neighborhood because we're so close to the United Nations. When we get to the corner, we're going to go left onto 49th Street and enter Turtle Bay Gardens, one of the loveliest residential neighborhoods on the east side. Even the trees are lovely, but be careful, they can hit you on the tops of your heads. And then our next stop will be the Waldorf Astoria Hotel. With the green top is the Helmsley Building. You can walk through the Helmsley Building over into MetLife and then into Grand Central Terminal, which is on the other side. Grand Central, the largest train terminal in New York, completed in 1980. Alright, the next stop of the tour will be the Rockefeller Center. Anybody from Rockefeller Center? Okay, we're going to leave you near. Well, I was going to say, we're going to leave you near the ice skating rink, but the ice skating rink is closed. We're going to leave you near this area. Uninterrupted 360-degree view of our city, and from the top of the rock, you can clearly see the Empire State Building. On the corner to the right, my favorite store in this neighborhood, Metropolitan Museum of Art gift shop. Keep looking to the right behind the flagstone, the famous flagstone.
Wow. I see when you're interested. It's between one of them are by Rural Winterburn. And it performs every Monday, 8 p.m. and 10 p.m. You might want to see him before he retires, because in June he's going to be 94. They're going strong.